Hi, this is Pankaj. Since we are living in an era of highly stressful life and competitive world, so we have to understand how to keep the healthier heart and internal organs. So before going for the introduction of the hypertension, we should know the definition of the hypertension. So hypertension basically we call as a high blood pressure. So there's a difference between the high blood pressure and normal blood pressure. So high blood pressure basically the stiffness and high tension and pressure in the arteries which carries the blood from the heart to the different part of the body. And then we have two numbers about the normal blood pressure. That is upper top number, this is systolic blood pressure, which equals to the pressure in the arteries when the heart contracts. And then diastolic and bottom number is basically when it equals to the pressure in the arteries when heart relaxes. So when you have supposed to consider whether you have a hypertension or not, or maybe the high blood pressure. So when you are going to check the blood pressure routinely after the age of 18 to 45 years, usually we used to get previously blood pressure after the age of 45 years. Since I told this era of highly stressful lifestyle and competitive world, so we have to keep an eye over the blood pressure after the age of 18 years only. So a lot of patient comes with a high blood pressure at the age of 20, 25, 30, 35 and without any risk factors. So we have a different kind of multifactorial mechanism of developing the hypertension. So we have two category of the hypertension. One is a primary hypertension, another one is secondary hypertension. Primary hypertension basically without any obvious reason. So the person may have a genetical predisposition in terms of the parents, one parent or both the parents might have a history of hypertension. So the risk becomes double compared to the general population. So what are the causes of hypertension? So basically development of hypertension on the based of the multifactorial means several factors involved in the development of the hypertension. First and foremost thing is a lifestyle, that is high intake of the salt or high sensitivity to the salt intake, especially in elderly people and obesity who are not doing the exercise. And second is the genetical predisposition, that means one or both the parents has a hypertension, so they have a risk almost double than general population. And third is a peculiar kind of condition in which you have a stiffness and thickness of the arteries which lead to the increased resistance in the smaller arterioles of the peripheral arteries in the body, so which increases the peripheral resistance and develop the hypertension. How to diagnose the hypertension? So practically, I would say, like, if you want to officially diagnose the hypertension, you have to check the blood pressure at the different sittings and different timings and different days. So you can monitor the blood pressure probably twice in a week, at least 4 to 6 weeks. If blood pressure is more than 130 by 80 millimeter mercury, we can consider it is a high blood pressure. But we have to keep an eye. It's not necessary to rush to the specialist or doctor, but we have to monitor the blood pressure. So there's a two different category of the blood pressures are there. One is called home blood pressure and another one is a hospital check blood pressure. That's called white coat blood pressure or office blood pressure. So it is a difference between the house blood pressure and blood pressure at the hospital. Definitely person goes to the hospital, there is a different blood pressure readings compared to the home blood pressure. So what are the complications can happen with high blood pressure? So blood pressure itself can lead to the multiple complications in the form of the stroke, heart attacks, heart failure, kidney problems and different retinal damages in the eyes. So before going for the treatment part, we should know the pathophysiology of the hypertension, how this develops in person. So in the form of the primary hypertension, so a lot of chemicals released because of stress in the body, which increases the peripheral arterial resistance. And then secondly, like secondary hypertension in the form of secondary disease like a kidney problem, or there's a stenosis or blockage in the renal arteries, and hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is also different kind of endocrine tumor, diabetes and probably because of the brain stroke also, you may develop the secondary neurogenic hypertension. So how to control the blood pressure? So before controlling blood pressure, we should have a preventive measures. That is more important. So always in medical science, like, prevention is the best medication in terms of any diseases. So you have to check the blood pressure with the doctor in the hospital blood pressure and home blood pressure and compare the readings. So if there is an increase in blood pressure more than 130 by 80, persistently you have to seek the help of the physician or cardiologist. Or if blood pressure is more than 160 by 100, you have to see an emergency with an emergency doctor, physician or cardiologist. So what are the preventive measures we can do in terms of the control of blood pressure? First and foremost thing is the lifestyle modification in the form of the dietary control, which is very important, and second is the physical activity and exercise. So we have a different kind of diets. So first and foremost thing is you have to cut down the salt. Usually recommended salt is 5 to 6 grams per day, but if somebody has a hypertension, you have to decrease the intake of the salt, probably less than 4 grams per day. And we have a DASH diet to control the hypertension. So DASH diet is basically a dietary approach to stop the hypertension, in which includes the increased intake of the whole grain, decreased salt intake, decreased fat intake, and lean meats intake. And definitely controlling the fat, salt, at the same time you have to do the physical exercise in the form of anything. Physical activity is much better than nothing. So you have to do basically cardiac exercise in terms of at least 35 to 40 minutes walk, jogging and cycling depending on the your tolerance. Every day, at least 5 days in a week, which reduces the weight and controlling the insulin resistance and diabetes and hypertension also. And in terms of secondary or alternative measures in terms of controlling the hypertension or prevention of hypertension, you have to do yoga, exercise or different kind of modalities which increases the intake of potassium. So potassium rich diet basically consists of a lot of fruits, but unless somebody has a kidney problem. And if these modalities are not going to control the blood pressure, at least we have to consider the physician, cardiologist or nephrologist depending on the requirement of the medical condition. So in those conditions, we can consider the medication or medical therapy, pharmacotherapy, because different categories of people require the different molecule. So like person has got the anxiety, stress, palpitation, and then different multiple comorbid condition. So we decide the molecule on the basis of the requirement of the clinical profile of the patients. And ultimately, hypertension is not only the public hazard, at the same time it burden on the economy of the family also. So which increases the risk of the heart attack, brain stroke and kidney problem, and increases the burden on the medical therapy also. So what are the symptoms person can have and when you're going to reach to the doctor? So person may not have any symptoms with hypertension. So like that's what we call the hypertension is a silent killer. Patient may have symptoms like dizziness, giddiness, headache, blurring of vision, palpitation in terms of increase in heartbeat during sleeping time, or maybe some kind of disorientation or difficulty in walking, weakness, lack of concentration. So I would like to conclude that. So hypertension prevention is the best medication in terms of control of hypertension, which reduces the risk of the major health problem. Thank you.